Hello everyone, this is Alejandro, and in this tutorial we will see how we can add sounds to your 3D objects. This is a new feature on Spline that enables you to do things like this. For example, when I click on the objects, they all play a different sound. This is very nice because now you can have more richer interactions on your 3D scenes. So you can also build experiences like this, and when I click on the little character or in the trees, you can see that they all have like a different sound. So we will see how we can create these little sounds using Spline. All right, let's begin. All right, so I have this little cube scene here, and what I want is that when I click on this little object here, this object will trigger a sound. So right now, if I go to the play mode and I click this object, nothing is happening. So how can I do this? Well, I just need to select this object, and then I'm going to add a new event here, which is going to be a play sound event. Click here on the four dots icon, and then I'm going to click in this one that is called bubble. So now if I go to the play mode and I click on this object, you can see that there is this very subtle sound of like a bubble type of sound, but I want to increase the volume. So I'm going to increase the volume here. I'm going to play a game. All right, so that's a little better. Just playing a sound on this object is not enough because it feels like it's not moving, right? So let's create like a very basic interaction there. So I'm going to create a new state for this object, and then I'm going to move the object a little bit to the top, and then I'm going to rotate the object like this. So now I'm going to create another event, and this is going to be a mouse sound event. And I want it to be toggled because I want to switch between one state to the other. And then I want to use a spring transition. So now if I play this animation and I click on the object, so you can see how the object is moving and it's also reproducing the sound. So what I want to do now is that I want to create like a background music for this scene. So I'm going to create a group object here, and then I'm just going to call this environment sound. So this object is not going to do anything. It's just a placeholder for me to have like a new event, and this event is going to be another play sound event. And then here I'm going to select start, and then I want to select here any input, which means that this sound is going to play after any input happens on the screen. So the reason why you need to select something in here is because on the browsers, the only way that a sound can be executed is that there is a previous interaction from the user. So this is actually like a browser constraint. All right, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to upload a sound that I have. This sound is called Relax. And now if we play this, you can see that as soon as I click anywhere on the screen, the sound on the background is played. I don't have any kind of looping, so at some point this sound is just going to stop right there. So there is no more background music. So what we want is that we want this background music to play forever. So I'm going to select here the looping to be infinite. All right, so now if I play my experience, so you can see that we have all of these interesting sounds and interactions, and we also have background music. All right, that's how you can add sounds to your themes. I hope you like this tutorial. See you in the next one. Bye bye.